Hello and a very warm welcome. You're watching Beyond Fine Print. I'm Molly Gambhir. The Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi has just wrapped up a two-day historic visit to Bangladesh, during which he participated in the country's 50th anniversary celebrations of its liberation. Five agreements have been inked between the two sides. A lot of symbolism attached to that visit. The Indian Prime Minister also handing over a box symbolizing the vaccines that have been gifted by India to Bangladesh. Strengthening of the partnership between the two countries has been the underlying objective of this visit by the Indian Prime Minister. Joining us on the broadcast this minute is Ambassador Bhaswati Mukherjee. Thanks very much, Ambassador, for speaking with us. I want to start by talking about the boost to connectivity, which is a key pillar of the partnership between the two countries. The Mitali Express passenger train service inaugurated now between Dhaka and New Jalpaiguri. The two prime ministers also gave the nod to the concept of the proposed road linking Kolkata in India and Mujibnagar in Bangladesh, which would literally bring the two nations together, closer.
Indeed, Molly, it's crucial. Connectivity is a crucial issue. And this is something that Bangladesh has long awaited for. The connectivity between Dhaka and Jalpaiguri on our side, which is historically very important for the Indo-Bangladesh spirit, shared history, etc., is going to make a huge difference, because now Bangladesh will be connected to India in so many more ways than just Kolkata and Dhaka. Similarly, the connectivity that we are now developing with Thailand and other countries, Dhaka can look forward to being connected on that route also, because it now will have multiple routes connecting Bangladesh with India. So it's going to make a very big difference, and this is something that they had been long asking for. So I think it is just wonderful that this has been announced in this visit. This must be something that would have been greatly welcomed by the Bangladeshi people and the media, and of course by the political leadership.
A lot of symbolism and significance attached to this visit. The very fact that the Indian Prime Minister chose to undertake this visit amid the COVID-19 pandemic tells us about the importance that India attaches to this relationship that it has with Bangladesh. What, according to you, has been the significance of this visit and the overall outcome of the visit by the Indian Prime Minister?
Well, I think one of the most interesting things that the Foreign Secretary said in his recently concluded press conference was he said that in the bilateral talks were intended to enhance the legacy and the spirit of 1971. I think that was very well said. Prime Minister's visit is supposed to commemorate three things very important for both countries. 100 years of the founding father of Bangladesh, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, 50 years of the bilateral relationship, and 50 years of the creation of Bangladesh, where India, its people, its armed forces stood shoulder to shoulder with the Mukti Bahini and the people for the creation of this country. So I think that the very fact that Prime Minister decided that his first visit overseas in 1.5 years almost would be to Bangladesh demonstrates that India has a very important historical, civilizational, and cultural connect. In fact, the connect between the Bangladesh and India is not religion-based at all, because the culture and civilization and the language that binds the two countries is demonstrated by what? By the fact that Bangladesh's national anthem has been composed by Rabindranath Tagore himself, Shonar Bangla. There couldn't be any other country in the world whose national anthem would be composed by the Nobel laureate of the neighboring country, India. So that itself demonstrates, as Foreign Secretary said, the legacy and spirit of 71. But more than that, Bangladesh is now coming of age. It is moving out of the LDC category. Its development and its GDP is fantastic, considering the condition in which Pakistan had reduced its former East Pakistan to. When East Pakistan gained independence, everybody thought it would be a basket case. So this is the time, actually, and India has demonstrated that by extending $1 billion in the third line of credit, by the vaccines that you've talked about, by the various pacts, five of them that have been signed. But more than that, the ambulances, all the things that Bangladesh has been asking us for, the support, the development cooperation, the call for Indian business to come, to see and to invest in the Bangladesh economy. These are the major takeaways of this visit. More than that, I think it is also important, Molly, for us to remember that Bangladesh has been assiduously wooed by the Chinese, who have not hesitated to use the Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan, despite the genocide which the Pakistani army perpetrated. The Pakistanis have quite shamelessly, in fact, tried to woo the Bangladeshis to move towards China. To counter that, we need to be very vigorous and very energetic. And Prime Minister's visit is precisely that. Prime Minister's visit and what Sheikh Hasina, the Bangladeshi Prime Minister, has said on Twitter and in her public pronouncements go a very long way to convey the message to China and Pakistan that this historical relationship, this friendship, the ties, they are not going to be affected by China trying to hold out money to Bangladesh, because we are there. We have given a lot of aid and much more is coming. And moreover, we understand Bangladesh's needs. Bangladesh is a democracy like India, and we do understand, and we are with them. And I think it's also very significant that on some of the irritants, notably the Rohingyas, the ambulances that we've given which will be used also in some of those camps. That's important. And also the fact that we have been working quietly with Myanmar now for quite a while to try to create those conditions for the return of the Rohingyas, who are afraid to go back. And the fact we have been building houses, we have been working through the UN, we've been working bilaterally with Myanmar, I'm sure will convey a very positive message to Bangladesh that we really do understand the problem they have, and that we do want the Rohingyas to return to their homeland. We know that Bangladesh has very little territory, and it is not possible for them to continue indefinitely to host the Rohingyas. They have to return home. That also, I think, which was discussed, is a major takeaway, that we made our position clear, that we are there to help Bangladesh and to help the Rohingyas to return home. So that is also very important.
Ambassador Mukherjee, appreciate very much for joining us. We On, now available in your country. Download the app now. Get all the news on the move.